next thing we need to understand the default traffic flow between the interfaces which are assigned to security zones. Like let's say I'm assigning this interface into a zone, let's say LAN, and this interface into some internet, and then this interface created with some name called DMZ and then assigned to this interface. Now these are the three security zones which, let's assume I have configured and then applied them to the interfaces. So by default, the traffic flow between any two zone interfaces will not go by default. Now there is no levels here. The traffic from LAN to internet will not be allowed by default, and the traffic from internet interface to LAN interface is not allowed by default. So by default, it is dropped. You need to specifically write a policy to allow the users sitting in the LAN to access internet. And if you want someone in the internet to access the LAN resources, specifically like servers, you need to write a policy. So firewall policies need to be configured to control what traffic should be allowed or denied. Whereas intra-zone traffic, intra-zone is like, let's take an example. I got one more interface. Maybe you got two LANs and I'm going to assign the same name as LAN. So we can assign two interfaces to the same security zones. And by default, the traffic between these two interfaces is allowed by default. So if you want to deny a specific traffic between these two interfaces, then we need to write some firewall policies. So if we don't write any kind of policies, the default traffic between the two interfaces assigned to the same zone will be allowed by default. And the next thing is the traffic between the defined zones and the self zones. Self zones means, let's say, you want to initiate a telnet connection from here, from this device. You want to initiate a telnet from this LAN interface, and by default it is allowed. So the traffic between any defined zones, user defined zones, and the traffic destined to the router, or maybe you initiate a traffic from here, by default it is allowed. And if you want to specifically control what traffic should be denied, like maybe you want to deny the router should not send any kind of OSPF messages on the outside interface, on the internet interface. At the same time, you may want to control, like the no one should from the outside interface should be able to telnet or SSH to my router, or should not be able to ping to my interface. In that case, we need to write a firewall policies to deny that particular traffic. So the default traffic flow, like between the interfaces, by default denied. And if you have any two interfaces assigned with the same security zones, it's allowed by default. And the traffic destined to the router or initiated from the router from any of the zone interfaces will be allowed by default.